Okay, I'm just going to get started, and you can join along if you're joining in a little bit late. This is, I know it's home live workout number 11, I think, but I'm not actually at home. I'm at my squash club, love the squash club. And this is an exercise, or this routine we're going to do today. Obviously, you can do it on a squash court. That's why I thought it'd be good to film it here because I have a bit more space, or you can go and do it outside in the backyard if you have a bit of room. You can do it maybe in the park. If you need a bit of space, don't need your racket. I like using my racket so I can actually go and try to visualize the swings that I'm taking and the shots that I'm hitting. But you don't need a racket. So if you don't want your racket, that's fine. It's going to be more about the movement. It's all going to be a lateral movement, so side to side, and there'll be some I'll call a close stance, which means getting on your front leg, and some of the open stance, which means getting off of your back foot. Okay, so just again, the close stance and open stance. Two important things to remember when you're doing ghosting, these are maybe the main flaws that I see with most people, is that when they go to hit, their posture is like standing completely upright, which is not what you would want when you're hitting a squash, any kind of squash early, but especially when you're hitting off the bat. So think about your posture. Trying to be in good posture, good hitting position, and also trying to make sure that I see a lot of people just go to the side and now they're still basically facing the front wall and they're like, this is not, you're not going to hit a good straight drive standing like this, right? So even if you're hitting off your open stance, your back foot, you want to still turn your hips and your shoulders as your rack goes back, and now you're actually squared to the side wall and you're going to hit a much more accurate shot. So those are the two key factors for today's session. The goal is to try to do sets of 20 shots, and again, you can do a little bit more, a little bit less. We're gonna aim for 10 sets. I don't have my sticky pad today and pen to keep track, so hopefully I get it right. And I think that's about it. So I'm gonna start, this is gonna be our first set. I'm gonna start off slow and simple, and then we'll get into some different footwork patterns, and then maybe speed it up after I get warmed up. Okay, so very simple, get started. It's just gonna turn, hit, close stance, and now I'm gonna come back, turn, hit, close stance. And you'll notice when I go through these shots, my racket, my fall through, now I'm ready for the next shot. So just 40 shots, 20 shots, sorry, 6, 30, maybe 40 seconds between sets, but I don't know about yet. So I'm just gonna chat a little bit, and when I feel like I'm ready, I'm gonna go to the next set. So the next one we're gonna do is gonna be off our front leg again, so close stance, except we're gonna go for two steps off of the tee. So it'll be like one, two, back to the middle, and now one, two. Okay, third set is done. So far I've hit drives on all my shots, but you can mix it up and play volley drives, bows, any shot you want. Okay, so maybe trying to use a bit of variety. If you're doing this on a squash court, trying to actually picture the shot, where it's landing, how high you're hitting, how hard you're hitting, and you know where that second bounce is coming, or if you're trying to get it tight to the side wall. Okay, so fourth set. It's going to be different open stance stands, so back up, depending on how long your legs are. So if I'm playing open stance and it's just one step, that's easy. But if it's further away, close to the side wall, I need to have an extra shuffle step to get up there. So for me, it would be like one, two, three. You can also go like behind like this, maybe a little bit slower. If you're a taller player, you might just do really quick little first step, and then a longer second, last little bit. So I don't know if you can quite see. I'll back up a little bit, just to make sure you can see where I'm going to. But basically, this one I'm going to pretend to play volley drives, and I'm going to play open stance. So it'll be like one, two, three, volley drive, back to middle, one, two, three. So just like that, back to middle. Okay, so here we go. you're doing this, you probably can't see what I'm going to explain here, but when I come back to the middle, how I'm in an athletic stance. Athletic stance just means I'm off my heels, my knees are going to be bent, I'm on my toes a little bit, so you're just free. Right? So you can kind of have a little momentum and push off of the tee. So that's our fifth set. Now we're going to switch to the other way. I'm going to do one step, open stance on the backhand, and then one, two, attacking, straight down drop on the forehand side. So volley drop, one step, everything's going to be on the left leg. So if you're, I guess if you're left-handed, same idea, you're going to be forehand volley drop. Stay on your toes with the tee. Still, a lot of my thinking when I'm doing ghosting is going to be about how I'm hitting different shots and how to make it more effective. So that's our seventh set. So we got three more. We're gonna try the same thing again, except we're gonna go, so two in a row, except we're gonna go open stance. Okay, so we're gonna go all the way over, back, and then again, fall back up again, just to make sure you guys can see. So again, open stance, back foot. For me, it's gonna be three little steps, one, two, three, bigger last step, and then back in. Open stance, and you can get those feet really moving quick. You notice when I do this, I'm coming back. I don't just go here. I go behind so I can get further, reach further on the next shot. Okay, so up to you if you want to be able to hit here and come back here. I'm trying to go a little bit further for my core coverage. Okay, so we'll do 24.
So let's do some core. I don't know.
better if I don't know what the clock says. Today I didn't have the camera pointing at me, so if anyone was texting, messaging, I couldn't see it. Thought it would be simpler when the camera was pointing at me. It puts it in reverse, so it looked like I was left-handed flush, which could have been confusing. Maybe it's pretty boring if you're not doing a workout. So if you're not, don't be really tuned out. But for those doing this with me or watching later on or on YouTube, then hopefully it'll stick through it. And I'll be able to push you a little bit. In the arms as much as the core. Maybe in the arms more than the core. Which means the core is probably stronger than the arms, upper body. Thank you. Hope you enjoyed it, and good luck with your squash game and your